today I'm going to be sharing with you my experience doing yoga every day for 30 days. As a beginner, I do want to add that because before I did this, I'd only ever been to probably 15 yoga classes in my entire life. And so I'm definitely still a beginner. So this is more like to inspire some other people out there who have never done yoga before, or maybe have only ever been to a few classes, to maybe get into it a little more if you want to. And I just want to kind of share my experience and talk about what I did and how it was and how I liked it and what I've kind of gotten from it, how I've benefited from it. So before this year, before 2019, I'd really only ever done yoga a few times in my life. I'd probably gone to like 3 or 4 classes when I was in like middle or elementary school with my mom, because she's done yoga for I think over 10 years, and occasionally I just went to check it out. And I didn't really like it because what we would do, I swear for like 20 minutes, I swear 50 repetitions of this, we would just do these things called sun salutations, which I think there are different like versions, ways you can do it. We would basically stand up, then we would forward fold, and then we would go into a halfway lift, and then we would go into a forward fold, and then we'd go back to high plank, low plank, upward dog, downward dog, back to forward fold, stand up, and repeat the entire thing. And we just do that over and over and over and over and over and over. And it was like so boring. But over the past couple years, I've really kind of regained an interest in doing yoga again, because I figured most classes probably are not the exact same and are not exactly like that one. And I've probably done yoga a few times here and there. I think like in 2018, I did yoga twice just on my own. And the thing is, I've never really been a huge fan of like watching yoga videos online and like doing the same flow as somebody like Yoga with Adriene. I've just never really been super into that. And I didn't have any knowledge of yoga poses to be able to make up my own flow. So I've never really into just doing it on my own. But at the beginning of this January, I think January 10th, one of my relatives invited me to a hot yoga class, which sounded really fun, especially because it was hot, and hot yoga classes I believe are heated from like 90 to 95 degrees in that range, and I love like feeling hot. I don't like being cold, so just like the idea that I was gonna be all sweaty, and that really appealed to me. And what's really awesome is the studio I go to has this offer for people I've never taken a class there before, that they get like everything for their first class for free. So I got the class for free. I had my own yoga mat because my mom had an old one that she didn't use anymore. And I got a towel because you're supposed to put like this thing called a yogi toe on top of it, so that when you're all sweaty, you're not like slipping around on your mat because of the sweat. And then they also give you a little towel to like wipe your forehead or your neck or wherever. I honestly loved it from like the second I stepped in the room, because in January in Wisconsin, it's kind of cold for the most part. And so just it being winter and stepping into like this super hot room that felt like a sauna. Not that I've ever been in a sauna, but what I assume a sauna feels like, oh, it was amazing. Just like being around a bunch of different people, it kind of like adds a certain element of this really good energy to your practice that you can't really get when you're just sitting at home doing yoga. And so I loved it, and I knew that I really wanted to get a monthly membership type of thing. And the place also does this awesome introductory special where you can go to unlimited classes for 30 days and get that for only $30, which is ridiculously cheap. I started it at the beginning of February, and for the first 2 or 3 weeks of that, I went probably 2 to 3 times a week. And then that's when I started my little challenge. I just wanted to challenge myself to see if I could do yoga for 30 days every single day. And I knew I could because I don't do anything else with my life, so like why would I not be able to? Up to that point, I'd only gone to 10 classes, but I was like, you know what, if I get tired and like I'm at a class and I'm sore, I can just do the modifications, because if you don't know a lot about yoga, there's so many different ways to modify every different pose. And even if you like can't do a pose at all, you can honestly just sit down on your mat and drink some water and no one cares. And the main kind of classes that they do there, and the main kind that I went to, were vinyasa classes. They were called All Levels Vinyasa, because of course there's tons of beginners there, but there's also people who've been doing yoga for 10 years and have gone to hundreds of classes, or like over 1,000 classes, you know. And so it's really cool because there's people like me who are looking around like not knowing what to do, and there's people who are doing like these crazy poses that are just like, what the heck. But during my 30-day challenge, I went to 18 of those regular 1 hour long All Levels Vinyasa classes, and I went to 2 that were 75 minutes, and those are a bit more tiring actually. Like, even though they're only 15 minutes longer, I really sweat a lot more in those classes. I also went to 2 slow flow vinyasa classes, which are really cool because what they do is they put like towels over the windows in the room so it's really dark in there, and then they light candles and put them all around the room. They have little like fairy lights, and it's still a challenging class, but everything you're doing is more slow, and so you're holding poses for longer. That's what makes it also a bit hard, but those are really fun as well. I went to 1 absolute beginner class, which was awesome because I kind of learned a little bit about like how to do specific poses, the correct form, and that really helped with a lot of different things. I went to 4 yin yoga classes, which are really nice because they're a lot more relaxing and rejuvenating, and you're not really working at all. You're doing things that are more like really good stretches rather than flowing from one pose to another to the next. I did 1 yoga nidra class, which is, if I'm remembering correctly, it was 20 minutes of just really light, slow movement, nothing hard, just kind of relaxing, and then 40 minutes of just lying on your back as comfortable as you can be in like this deep state of relaxation. And then I did 2 guided meditations, which I know aren't exactly yoga, but for the first half of them, we were doing a little bit of light movement, and then the later half, 30 minutes, we were doing like a guided meditation. And I kind of made it like my mission to try all the different kinds of classes that they have there, all the ones that would like make sense for me to try, because they have like a Yoga Sprouts one, which is for little kids. Obviously, I'm not gonna go to that one, but I tried, I think, all of the ones that they have there, and I wanted to go to like all the different times of day. And so usually I'd go to ones that are like 4:45, 5:30, 6:30 p.m. Occasionally I went to some morning ones. I did go to some 5:30 a.m. ones. My favorite one was 8 to 9 p.m., which was really cool because it was just like dark out. It just had this really cool vibe to it. And I also wanted to experience the different ways that all the different teachers taught. And I haven't been to all of them yet. I think there's still a few that I have not taken a class from, but most of them I have. And in the beginning, I always sat in the back row because I was like, oh my gosh, I suck at this. People are gonna judge me. And then once I realized that nobody's judging me, nobody's judging anyone, I gradually went to the next row up. There's only 4 rows in the place I go to. Like, I don't live in some huge city, so the studio is kind of small. But I went to the second row from the back, and then gradually I went to the second row from the front. I've never sat in the front row because usually when you're a beginner, you don't, you know, stand up there so everyone can see you do everything wrong. But I like that it's kind of helped me go out of my comfort zone in just another aspect of life. And because, like I said earlier, I'm not really doing anything with my life, another thing I really liked about it was it kind of got me out of the house and just gave me something to do every day, something to look forward to every day, something to give me like a good reason to feel kind of tired and at the same time energized, because before this I felt like tired for no reason, and now my body feels physically tired in a like a bit, not terribly tired, but a bit more tired than usual. But I also am like waking up earlier, and I just in general feel more like excited and lively. It was also really nice to kind of push myself physically again, because I really haven't been too active in the past few months before then. And I'm someone who, like, in the past, in elementary and middle school, I did like so many different sports throughout my life, And I really liked the sports where you could really push yourself individually. It wasn't about competition. Like, I always liked cross country a lot, and I liked cycling on my own, non-competitively. And I missed being able to push myself physically and, you know, do things that were like kind of difficult, but then when you accomplish them, you feel good and you're like, hey, you know, I can do a lot more than I think. I like that it's got me to drink a tiny bit more water, which probably like cancels itself out with how much I sweat throughout the class, but I do need to work on drinking more water, and that has kind of helped. Something that I didn't really care about was like getting more flexible, but I'm actually really surprised how much more flexible I've gotten in, you know, like the, I think I've gone to 42 classes total since the beginning of the year. I've really only been doing yoga consistently for 2 months, and so I'm really surprised at how flexible I've gotten from it, which is, it's fun. Like, it's fun being more flexible, and I didn't really think of that before I really started doing it more consistently, but I guess that's a benefit. I've really liked how it has helped me become a lot more aware, mainly during class, not really so good at this outside of class, but it's helped me become more aware of like the places where my body's holding tension, which is pretty much always the same three places. My shoulders every now and then, but the two places where it's really bad is my eyes, because I just squint a lot, and if I'm closing my eyes, I don't just like close them, I go like this. And I also clench my jaw all the time. And like, so there's just so much tension in my face, and when I'm breathing and like focusing on my breathing and focusing on my body and how it's feeling while I'm going through the movements during yoga, I notice it a lot more, and I am able to correct it and be like, okay, stop clenching your jaw for no reason. Something that I think is really cool is that because the environment there is like so accepting, and people aren't, you know, judging everyone else for what they look like or how well they're doing some pose, I feel like everyone's like so much more comfortable really being who they are and not hiding certain things. You know, not everyone who goes there is stick thin, perfect body, and it's so inspiring and empowering, I feel like, to see so many people who really feel comfortable in their imperfect bodies, if you know what I mean. You know, like girls who are just wearing sports bras and leggings, and you know, they have fat rolls on their stomachs like a lot of people do, like I do, and they just don't seem to care. Maybe they do, I suppose. I can't, you know, read their minds, but to an extent they're like, they're confident enough to be like, hey, I don't have to have a perfect body for other people to see what I really look like. Or one time I was behind this guy who wasn't wearing a shirt, and he had a lot of acne and acne scars on his back, and that kind of like empowered me in a way, because I have a lot of acne like right here, and acne scars are as well too. And there was a time in my life when I was really insecure about that, and I would never, you know, wear shirts that would show my acne or my acne scars. But when you realize that like no one there cares, and in general in life people don't really care, but it's just, I don't know, for some reason I feel empowered by like seeing other people who don't look absolutely perfect being okay with the fact that they don't look absolutely perfect in society's standards. And I also really think it's cool that there's like so many different kinds of people there. You know, we might think of people doing yoga being like 25-year-old girls, but it's a lot more than just that. There's like 50-year-old guys in there who you just never expect to see there, and they're like pretty good. And so you can tell they've been doing it for a long time, and it's just, it's really cool to see like people who are younger than me there. I saw somebody there who's probably like 13 or 14 years old with, I'm guessing, her mom. There's people who are in their like 60s or maybe even 70s. There's just a bunch of different people there, and it's really cool. Another thing that I really, really liked, especially about the hot aspect of the yoga, was that because it's hot, you really have to focus on your breath more. And I know that in the times that I had done yoga in the past, I just didn't pay attention to that at all. But you really have to like be aware of your breathing, because if you don't breathe, then it's gonna be a little bit hard. And you're also breathing a lot heavier, and because not only you're breathing heavier, everyone else is, it's like just kind of this rhythm of in and out and in and out. And for a lot of the class, everyone's breath is kind of like in sync. And because you can hear that, it really makes you remember to breathe and breathe deeply, which I really need a reminder for that. You know, I'm sure there's a lot of other things that I really like about it that I won't remember until like 5 minutes after I finish making this video or while I'm editing it. But the last thing I wanted to say is that just in general, it's just so fun for me. And like, not everyone's gonna be the same because my mom tried hot yoga once and she did not like it. She likes to be cold. She always keeps her house freezing cold. So it wasn't really her thing. And yoga in general isn't really gonna be everyone's thing. But for me, it was just something that like right when the first day that I started, I knew I was gonna like it a lot. And now that I've gone to the classes that I have, I feel like so much more excited about just sitting at home, sometimes not even taking out my yoga mat, but just like doing random poses here and there or just stretching. It's so much more like of something I'm drawn to than I was before I had gone to those classes. And if you're kind of interested in doing yoga, whether it's hot yoga or not hot yoga, let me know if you have any questions that like me as a beginner could answer. I'm not gonna be able to give you anything super in depth, but if you want to know like anything else about my first experience going to class, if you're nervous to go to a class, maybe I can answer some questions. I don't know, maybe not. But yeah, I would love to talk about yoga more on my channel just because it's something that, as you can probably tell, really excites me. I'm really passionate about it. And so maybe in like future vlogs I do, I'll show some yoga flows, some beginner yoga flows where you cringe at how bad I'm doing the poses. But that's all I have to say. Today's quote is kind of not really related to what the video is about, but whatever. It's said by Deepak Chopra and it says, "The more you expand your awareness, the more naturally you will be present without effort."